Oh, we went to war with Iraq, with Libya. Except they don't call it war, they call it a no-fly zone enforcement. And it saddens me and angers me that we're doing it. Because I never hear what our criterion is, and I think that the news and our government owes that to the people to be specific about what our criterion is. France is in on it. Germany opted out. Oh no, they said no, and Germany is right. The the government of Gaddafi's tanks and aircraft have been used on civilians. Well, these civilians, unarmed civilians, well, these so-called unarmed civilians are aggressively attacking the army with weapons. You know, so whenever there is conflict, yes, unarmed civilians get killed. It's ludicrous. It's such a contradictory thing. It's disgusting that this country is the aggressor and couches it in terms of, well, France declared they were going to do it, and the United Nations backed them, and we voted for it, and we told them we'd support them. Well, of course, this country is the major aggressor. Those 100 cruise missiles that were initially launched were ours. And of course, they're going to kill the very civilians that we're supposed to be protecting. And don't get me started. It's, you know, we're not told the facts. And the reason the government gets away with this is that it tickles people's fancy. Oh, they get their patriotic pride up. I know I could feel it. Oh, the awesome power of those planes coming off a carrier. The awesome power of those cruise missiles coming off a destroyer. Sure, I feel patriotic. Let's kick butt. And then the reality hits me immediately that it here we are again, bombing the hell out of a two-bit dictator that it's up to the people to overthrow this guy. It's just wrong. It's just wrong. And you know, the pilots want to do it. The carrier group wants to do it. The sailors on the on those cruise missile ships want it. They all want to do it. The submarine, a British submariner launched some missiles. You know, the French have launched Mirages. And you know that the governments of us, of the people, are playing the people like a fiddle because they know that they can strum the patriotic strings. You know, we've all practiced, practiced, practiced. Yeah, let's play the real game. And you know, these guys on the ships are probably high-fiving one another. Good job, good job, good job. And it makes me sick because it's no contest. Because don't forget that there are people, not all of them, but there's enough of them that support that guy and that look at our and anyone coming into their country, declaring war on their country. They look at that as a challenge that they're going to meet, and they're never going to forget. And you better believe that we're never going to get thanked by anyone. So why are we doing it? Does Gaddafi have oil? I guess he does, doesn't he? The American people don't know what's going on. And like I say, those patriotic strings are being plucked. I've been there. I've felt that, unquestionably. Got in a big argument once with about Britain's attack on the Falklands. Of course, I was 100% behind the British. I remember back when, 84, we were bombing the hell out of somebody, and I was saying, yeah, we should do it, yeah, we should do it. But it was, my questions started coming when we were bombing the hell out of Serbia, and I saw what the people who were within earshot of those bombs were feeling, because They weren't texting. There was no texting back then, but they were getting on the internet, the old telephone connections, and they were telling what they were feeling, and you could just feel the opposite point of view. You see, we never went into China when they were hurting their people. We never went into Russia when Stalin was hurting his people, and he killed millions. We don't go into Africa, where they're slaughtering each other like flies. Of course, Libya is North Africa, as Gaddafi is, as had aspirations of being the king of. But Jesus Christ, why is it the people? Well, the people are evolving in their intelligence and their ability to see that these things don't just happen out of altruism, that the strings are being pulled for the non-spoken motives of God knows who, big business, getting reelected. But it has nothing to do with a consistent and well-defined policy of this country toward. No, it's, I can picture it. There's that element of we've got all these football players. We've got the carrier player and the destroyers player and the cruisers player and the submarines player. And we got the Marines in there. You know, that made the news that one of the Navy F-18 went in and jammed the radar and the Marines followed in there. What is it, the British jet that can go backwards and forwards and up and down. The Harrier jet. And you know, it, when you first hear it, you feel so patriotic. You know, go Marines! Go Navy! But this is not a fucking football game! Son of a fucking news just eats it right up, you know. Yeah, sells automobiles and everything else. Damn it.